probably thought Howard was a piece of cake, a route waiting to be taken. All I know is that Louis didn't make any more trouble for any of us. A new trouble was lurking just around the corner. By then we had sold the house to the Texans and were living in a small house on a lake in New Canaan. The Texans were throwing a big housewarming party, and they invited us. It was a little weird, I thought, going back to my old house when someone else owned it, but Deb convinced me to go. We weren't there 5 minutes before a guest came up to us and offered us some love. I went up to the bathroom with her and Deb, and I didn't take any, but she and Deb did a few lines and they got back down. We went back downstairs and Deb started dancing with Joe Kelly's attractive wife, who was equally drunk. They were both so out of it that they fell on the floor at one point. Deb went to the bathroom, probably to do some blow, and Kelly's wife came over to me. "Do you know that your wife is fucking my husband?" she said out of nowhere. "What? My husband is fucking your wife?" she said. "I don't know anything about that," I said. "Well, I do," she said, and walked away. My mind started reeling. I remembered that they had taken Deb with them on a vacation to Jamaica about a year ago. The three of them were probably fucking each other in Jamaica. I stayed home with Jean Hadley, and when I picked Deb up at the airport she came off the plane looking like both Derek. Her hair was all in braids, she was stopping traffic, and there was her schlumpy husband with the kid. It didn't even cross my mind that she had been cheating on me. I was so in love with Deb, and this love was certainly blind. Ace had tried to get me to the situation. One day he came over after I had gotten out of rehab and we were in the back, fixing the mopeds. Joe Kelly came over and he was in the house with Deb for hours. "What's this fucking guy doing in your house for 2 hours? Ace asked me. "He's a friend of ours," I said. "When I was in the hospital, he helped him." "Yeah, I'm sure he helped himself to a lot of things, including your wife's pussy," Ace said. So when we got home from the Texans party, I told Deb what Joe Kelly's wife had said to me. "Are you fucking this guy?" I asked her point blank. "No. She's drunk. She's out of her mind," Deb said. "Why would she say you fucked her husband?" I was so confused. I didn't want to acknowledge the truth. But it hit me over the head when I went into a bar in New Canaan one night to get a drink. By then we had left the lake house and moved to a townhouse near the bar. I walked in and Joe Kelly was in there drinking. He saw me and he turned white as a ghost. He lived 10 miles away in Darien. Why would he be at this little pub around the corner from my place in New Canaan? Deb kept putting the pressure on me to make the move to California. She and Sean had really worked on me that time Sean had come out to stay with us before I went to rehab. They both got me going, saying that my solo records had failed, that I was going nowhere here. Living full time in California never appealed to me. I almost died in a car crash there. But the two of them were like stereo magpies in my ears. "You can work at A&M. You love that studio," Sean said. He knew just what buttons to push. "Your grandfather is up in San Francisco. You can see him more often." They convinced me one night. Then I went to rehab. Shortly after I got back from rehab, my grandfather George died of cancer and I was devastated. California seemed distant after that. But we had sold the house and had some money. Besides, we wanted to live in a townhouse in New Canaan anyway. Deb started working on me again. "I think I'd like to go back home," she said one night. "We can get a place in El Dorado. Right now you can make a fresh start. All the record companies are out there. You know everybody." "All right, let's do it," I said. Someone should have walked into my house and shot me the minute those words left my lips. I should have been put out of my misery and spared the consequences. Sunset Strip and Hollywood Boulevard. Deb went out to California a month before we moved out and found a place to rent, with an option to buy. It was on a cliff in Palos Verdes. We had a ginormous living room with a spectacular view of the ocean. There was a small two-seater balcony off the living room. Both our bedroom and the kitchen also overlooked the ocean. If you went up one flight, there was Jean Ali's room, the guest room where I was going to set up my drums, and a large room with a pool table and all my gold and platinum albums. If you went out the sliding doors, there was a huge deck with a large swimming pool overlooking the ocean. Above us were just cliffs and rocks. This was like a movie star's house. And it was costing us a movie star's salary. We even had an elevator. Other than the occasional piece taken in the swimming pool, it was paradise. Eventually I thought I'd start a band and write my book, but first I just wanted to enjoy California, get a tan, swim in the ocean. For the first year there, I thought awful. We'd go to Deb's parents' house every Sunday for a big family dinner. After a few months out there, I felt like a different man. I was actually mellow. I felt good about Deb. I didn't fear that she was sneaking off and fucking Joe Kelly. We were a tight, and little family. On Friday afternoons, I'd take my sports car down the hill and rent 4 or 5 movies and bring back a couple of shopping bags filled with Chinese food. I didn't miss playing at all. I was a man of leisure. I woke up and went to sleep with Jihad. TV. During the commercials, I'd go to the kitchen for a snack and grab Deb's ass. Life was pretty comfortable then. Deb and I didn't have that much in common, so I made an effort to try to get into some of the things that she enjoyed. Deb liked golf, so I started playing. I was a natural at it, and it was something we could do together. I had a funny incident happened to me playing golf. I was in the men's locker room and these black guys came in to play around. They took one look at my long hair and one guy said, "Shoot, I didn't know they allowed women in the men's room." "Yeah, we've all come a long way, brother," I said. When Deb and I got into drinking together, it never worked out so well. We just didn't get along when we got drunk. Even when we were sober, we'd still fight. Not enough. Bruising and battling fights of our earlier days, but enough to keep you on your toes. After about a year or so of fucking off, I began to get the music itch again. It started when I took Jean Ali to A&M Studios to visit. They all knew me there and they would let us come in and they would show her all the consoles. By the spring of 1986, I was ready to make a move. I had heard that the group Steppenwolf was looking for a drummer, so I met with their manager, Ron. It seemed like a good fit for me. They played real steady, many beats, straight, and had rock and roll. I'm impressed that the drummer of this would come down for a job with Steppenwolf, Ron said. But I'll tell you right off the bat, John Day is no way going to have a drummer bigger than him in the band. He'd go crazy. Apparently, Kate was a control freak. Everything was business first, and they toured in a good venue that Kate had designed, playing the same reliable places every year. But Rob had gotten a tape from a new group that featured a chick singer named Jean. Her husband was in the band, too, and they wrote the songs together. He told me they were looking for a drummer. I went down and listened to them, and I thought they were pretty good. Jean was just adorable. She was around 5'6" with unbelievably beautiful legs, the greatest ass, and big pouty lips accentuated by her gleaming red lipstick and framed by long, curly black hair that gave her a gypsy look. She'd have a guitar hanging off her she couldn't play in her shell, but it looked cool. Her husband played bass and he was good, looking, and they had this guitarist who was trying to stop drinking so he could smoke all the time, but Jane wouldn't let him smoke in the locker room, and so he was going